You all are certainly a happy bunch. And that's grand. I like happy people. I really do. Give yourselves another round of applause. Oh, yes. Bless your hearts. May I see your hand if you know anything about love? Some hands didn't go up. Some hands didn't go up. Now, come on now. All right, we're going to talk about love, y'all. Yes, we are.
It's all right.
And it's a sad kind of love. And it's a kind of a sad experience, but you know, to kind of get you in the mood for it. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child, alone ways from home, alone ways from. Love makes the world go round, so they say. What keeps your world going round when you didn't get no love way back when? Way back there when you didn't know nothing. When you didn't know nothing about nothing except sleeping and getting fed and crying cause you was wet or cause your diaper was full. And even though you didn't know nothing and couldn't say nothing, you was already asking that question. Do you love me? I mean, do you love me? Do you love me? And you knew the answer even then. You could tell by the eyes, by the voice, by the feel of the hands when they touched you. And if the answer was no, oh, precious God, that's when death began. The death that was to become your shadow, your heartbeat, your smell. And you can believe me when I tell you that the absence of love is death. Just as sure as the sun rises in the east and sets in the west, the absence of love is death. And every hour of your life from then on is turned into a war between you and death. And you fight it. Fighting is easy in the beginning. You see, because you figure if you're polite and obedient and you don't get your clothes too dirty, she won't have no choice but to love you. And when that don't work, you become what they call an overachiever. Now, what that means is your report card has nothing but A's and B's. It means you'll always learn the longest speech for Easter Sunday. Mm-hmm. It means you become head majorette. It means you win a scholarship to graduate school. And when the answer is still no, you spend money. You spend money on sewing machines and car payments and water and light bills, etc., etc., etc. And when even that don't work, you run from her, yourself, and everybody else. And you look for a hiding place. You don't know it, but that's what you're looking for. But even when it looks like you might have found one, you start running again. Because by now, you can't believe, y'all. You can't believe in yourself, and you can't believe in nobody else. There are moments, of course, but that's just what they are. Moments. And in those moments, you feel so peaceful. You feel so free. You feel like you know how to get anything you want. But like I said, moments. You're lucky if you have 3 in 40 years. So where does all this leave you? I'll tell you where it leaves you. It leaves you up the creek without a paddle, and the waters of death take you wherever they please. It leaves you locked in a dark room, and your eyes forget how to deal with light. It leaves you frozen with your knees up under your chin and both thumbs in your mouth. And even though you're constantly moving, you're going nowhere. And only God can help you.
Amen, sister.
Amen. All right. Amen. All right. Amen. All right.